Bro, Islam teaches you it's okay to slap your own wife.
The more you read this verse, the more you learn. Men are the caretakers of women, as men have been provisioned by Allah over women and tasked with supporting them financially. Here's the main part. And if you sense ill conduct from your woman, advise them first. If they persist, do not share the bed, but if they still persist, then discipline them gently. But if they change their ways, do not be unjust to them. Surely Allah is the Most High, All Great.
And Cactus Boy, can you tell us why would a caretaker need to physically beat women under his care? Why would a man need to physically strike a woman for any reason? Can you think of a good reason? And what does the Quran say? Wadribhunna, beat her. And what else does the Quran say? If you fear nushuz, just for fearing nushuz, what is nushuz? Rebellion, disobedience, just for that, you're gonna beat her? Yeah, that's what I call divine wisdom. Sure, buddy. The Quran in 2.282 says that when you do a transaction, find two men to witness it. And if you can't find two men, then find one man and two women. Why two women, you ask? Well, just in case one of the women is, the other one can remind her. In today's day and age, we have a word for that. It's called misogyny. Why would a woman forget? Is she deficient in memory or intelligence? Well, we get the explanation for this in a hadith by Muhammad in Bukhari. Yes, she is. The Prophet said, "Isn't the witness of a woman equal to half of that of a man?" The women said, "Yes." He said, "That is because of the deficiency of a woman's mind." There you have it. Islam, the most feminist, beautiful religion for all humans.
Yeah, that's probably because Abu Bakr is Aisha's father and Umar is Hafsa's father. And they were both disciplining their daughters because they were asking for extra money from the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Are they not allowed to discipline their daughters? And also, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, would have stopped that immediately if he would have smacked his daughter very hard and hurt her, either of them. If they were to do that to their daughters, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, would not allow that. He does not like any women getting hit.
If my daughter did something inappropriate, say for example, asking her husband for money, well, first of all, if it's my daughter, I would ask her, why are you asking for money? Is this some unmet need of yours that's not being taken care of? Is your husband not providing for you properly? Is he not taking care of you for some reason? I wouldn't smack her. That's the last thing I'd do is. Here we have a hadith in Sahih Bukhari where Aisha is actually admitting that the Muslim men, their wives, Aisha said, they are suffering more than any other women she's seen. So she's saying that the wives of Muslim Sahabi were suffering because they were being beaten. And guess where this idea of beating the wives was allowed? It's in the Quran. Chapter 4, verse 34 allows you to beat your wives. And this is the consequence. A book that allows you and says it's from God, that says it's okay to beat your wives. Well, what do you think is going to happen? People are going to beat their wives if they really believe it's from God, right? And this is a woman coming and complaining to Aisha saying, look at this. This is horrible. I mean, this is just sad. This is what you get from Islam. Do you know that Muhammad actually gave bad advice to his companions once? Here's an example. He actually came to them and he told them, "Hey guys, don't do this. Don't cross-pollinate your trees." Guess what happened? They followed his advice and the trees didn't grow. Then when they asked him, he's like, "Oh, I'm just a man. If I give you advice about this world, I don't know, sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong. If I give you advice from God, then I'm always right." Islamic Science 101. Muhammad wants to teach us where the sun goes. Muhammad asked Abu Dhar, "Do you know where the sun goes when it sets?" Abu Dhar said, "Allah and his apostle know best." Muhammad said, "It goes and prostrates underneath Allah's throne." Islamic Science 101. Muhammad asked his companion, I guess he wanted to sound smart, "Do you know where the sun goes when it sets?" Now imagine this was way back when they didn't know, right? And Abu Dhar, the companion, said, "Allah and his apostle know best." Muhammad said, Islamic science, "It goes and prostrates underneath Allah's throne." There you have it, folks. If you ever wondered where the sun goes when it sets, it's not that the earth is going around the sun, it's that the sun is going beneath Allah's throne. Muslims claim that Muhammad was best to his wives.
What you have to realize is that Muslims follow the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and are told to within the Quran. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The best of you is he who is best to his wife." And he also said, "Those who abuse their wives are not the best of you." These are all steps taken before divorce, as you'll see in the next verse.
According to the seerah, Muhammad got so mad at his wives that he boycotted them for an entire month. And then Allah revealed this verse, threatening the wives, saying that Muhammad could get better wives, virgins, pious, repentant, worshipping ones. Was Muhammad really such a good husband that he had to use Allah to threaten his wives like this? Why were his wives so unhappy with him? What was he doing that was so bad? No, I'm not scared of discussion. I really don't mind. The only time I delete comments is if someone is threatening me or being extremely vulgar or nasty. But if you go to my blog, abdullahsamir.com, comments are still open, or on my YouTube. Who am I? If you don't know who I am, my name is Abdullah Samir. I'm an ex-Muslim making content mainly on YouTube. I'm also on Twitter, and now I'm on TikTok.